Yo, and I came from there to here. Yo, what up everyone? Right now, as you can see, I'm in my room in front of my computer. That's because I'm here to make a reaction on the video which I came across in YouTube. A person talking about Nagaland as a dangerous state. I don't know what made him say so, but let's not talk too much. Let's just get inside the video and see what this person is talking about.
Hello friends. Welcome to our YouTube channel, The Shocking Truth. Friends, Nagaland is the only state in India whose majority of people don't use a particular language to interact with each other. And the majority of them eat the meat of dog too.
Oh my god, right from the beginning itself, this video says that Nagaland is the only state in India which don't have a major language, which is totally wrong. In Nagaland, there are many tribes, but there is one major language spoken by everyone, that is called Nagamese. And secondly, this is the common problem which we face once we are out of the Northern States, eating dog meat. I know some people, and this is very sensitive, like topic, because some people take care of dog as their own family, and they keep dog closed. They look after them. Those are not the dog which I'm talking about here. There are animals which we rare to produce meat, so those are the dog which I'm talking about, and that is what we Northeast people eat. I don't eat dog meat, but I'm just saying for those who are not from Northeast states. And secondly, this is like the food in it's an individual's choice, so nobody has a right to judge the other person from what he eats. Unless, he don't come and steal away your dog and eat, and that's a different case, but otherwise it's fine. And, one thing, Northeast people also should be very careful once we step out of the Northeast states. If you want to have a dog meat, don't get caught. But in case you get caught, make sure you tell them that not all the Northeast people eat dog meat, because I don't eat dog meat and there are many people who don't eat dog meat. But otherwise, it's a personal choice. Do what you want, eat what you want. If you don't want to eat, I guess you have to better shut your mouth. I think so. Yeah, let's get
which is not so common in India. So today I'm going to tell you some mind-blowing facts that most of you are not aware of.
Okay.
So let's begin. Nagaland is a small state situated in the northeast part of India,
mm-hmm.
having a population of around 20 lakh, which is somewhat.
Okay, he's talking about Nagaland, but I don't see any footage, of Nagaland or anything. Instead, I see grass, trees and a footpath. These are not even from Nagaland. I think this must have he must have shot this behind his backyard. He must be going around like Nagaland is a dangerous state because they eat a dog meat. Yeah, this is a footage from behind his backyard, or I don't know. Let's continue.
But less than some of the major Indian cities since
yeah, now I see this must be his toilet, so which means that this must be from his backyard. He should have at least closed his toilet when he took this footage. I think he's trying to promote his backyard.
India is a Hindu majority country. Then also, 88% of people who belongs to Nagaland follows Christianity. Most of the area of Nagaland is covered with mountains and dense forest.
Let's play back that once again. Oh my god.
With mountains.
Okay, he's talking about a mountain here. Let's see, mountain, I see rhinoceros.
And dense forest.
Alright. Mountain! Then he shows us a rhinoceros. Rhinoceros is not even there in Nagaland. If there is, then we would have had that for dinner, because that is going to give us more meat than dog. And that is going to last, for about a week, for about a month, I don't know. And this is not a dense forest, you idiot. This is a person with their traditional costume. So if you're talking about an elephant, don't put donkey in place of that. Let's just continue.
There are more than 100 tribes and each tribe has its own language. That's why they don't have any particular language to interact with each other.
More than 100 tribes in Nagaland? I have never heard that before. Because there is no 100 tribes. There are only 16 tribes in Nagaland. I don't know. Where did he get this information?
Most spoken language in Nagaland is Ao, which is spoken by only 12% of people.
Oh my god, he's talking about an Ao. Ao is one of the 16 tribes in Nagaland. And like I said at the beginning, in Nagaland, Nagamese is the major language spoken by everyone.
Majority of the tribes used to wear a kada in their legs, which is found really beneficial while climbing a tree.
Is he trying to be funny or what is this? Who wear this to climb trees? He said kada. He must be kada if he's wearing this to climb trees. Let me show you a proper one. That is a proper picture. Don't just show feet and, you know, with that ring attached to that feet and say that this is good for climbing trees. This must have been worn by people from Rajasthan. I don't know, I'm just saying, because it's not from Nagaland. And he must have tried, you know, wearing this, and he must have tried climbing coconut trees. So that is the reason why I think he's trying to say that this is good for climbing
trees. According to the culture of Nagaland, the tribal used to wear a colorful bed sheets.
Okay, that is not even funny. That is kind of offensive. That is not a bed sheet, idiot. That's a traditional, you know, costume attire, you know, worn by a different state to represent a different culture from a different state.
And they have a culture of eating dogs too. They get this culture from their forefathers.
Okay, we're talking about a dog here again. Like I said in the previous, you know, food is a personal choice unless they don't come and steal away the dog which you look after and care, you know, like your own family members. But otherwise, you would. Well, they are eating the animal which they rare to produce meat. So, and this is the picture. This picture is not even from Nagaland. This must have been taken from China or Thailand. This is not even from, you know, like from any Nordic parts of the, not from all, any Nordic states, because we don't sell dog meat in this way.
Which they practice from thousands of years. But there are some people who doesn't believe in eating dogs. There are some tribes who gives a big importance to their dreams.
Okay, he's talking about a Nagaland, but I see here people from Manipur with their traditional attire, so
they believe that they are able to see future through it. It is found that some of the tribes are really dangerous for the outsider, so it is better to take precautions while visiting to some part of Nagaland. While
okay, which part of Nagaland is dangerous? There is no parts in Nagaland which is dangerous. Nagaland is a very peaceful state. People are very friendly. People are very welcoming. People are very simple. And the skeleton and the person that you see with the traditional attire, that picture must have been taken back in maybe around 60, 70 or 80 years back. So, and we are in 2018, so I don't know what that picture has got to do with right now.
Most of the area is totally safe. Most of the peoples of India thinks that the people of Nagaland is backward and they used to hunt animals to earn their livelihood. But most of them don't know that the literacy rate of Nagaland is 80-85%, which is better than other part of the country. The interesting part of the Nagaland is that 80% of their population is linked with agriculture, but they don't like to eat vegetables.
That is funny. 80% of the people are engaged in agriculture, but they don't eat vegetables. Who don't eat vegetables, you sucker? Vegetables, if you have been to Nordics, you will know that, you know, just outside our own house, we always cultivate a small kind of vegetable garden. So vegetable is a must, even if we don't have you know, meat like fish, chicken. Vegetable is a must. So we do eat vegetable for your kind information.
The shocking truth of Nagaland is that you cannot burst cracker there. However, in many parts of Nagaland, sometimes the bomb bursts more than crackers due to terrorist attack.
Okay, crackers are allowed to burst with a certain amount. And now this is all over India that, you know, you're not allowed to crack as much as you want because of the pollution problem.
In Nagaland, you will send to jail for drinking alcohol, but you can drink whiskey, rum and beer. It is completely allowed by the government.
Okay, I don't think he knows the difference between alcohol, whiskey, rum. And nobody will send to jail if you drink unless you smuggle, because as you know, Nagaland is a dry state, which means that you're not allowed to sell wine openly, but you're allowed to do everything and with a certain limitation. But otherwise, it is fine unless you don't drink too much, you know, get drunk and go back home and then start you know, hard rock concert with your wife, then it is fine. But otherwise, drinking is not a crime in Nagaland or in any parts of the Northern states.
According to their culture, Lots of festivals are practiced in Nagaland. Due to this reason, it is also known as the land of festivals. Among the all festivals, the most lovable festival is Hornbill, which is practiced from 1st of December to 10th of December. So friends, how's this video?
So friends, how is this video? Just shut your mouth. Well, I think I said what I need to say. I paused many times in between the videos because there are many things which were said and which was not true. And not just in Nagaland, but in Northeast, though we have a small eyes, but then we have a big heart. We are very simple, we are very welcoming, you know. We are very friendly people. So whatever the information was given on this video, I don't think you should take. You should just take 1% of what he said, but otherwise the rest are all not okay. Yeah, I have said what I need to say. If you have anything to say, you can just leave a comment and make sure you subscribe because I'm about to reach 1 million subscriber very soon. I'm just kidding. Yeah, but yeah, I think that's all, I guess. Anything? Did I not mention anything yet? No. Alright, thank you for watching.